Hi, welcome to Uber Micro Repairs. Today on the healing bench we have a PS5 SCUF Reflex FPS and it's faulty. Surprising. We have the customer's note right here. Please see enclosed my SCUF PS5 Reflex FPS for repair. There are some issues that need repairing. This thing's brand new. Right 2 digital trigger faulty, not working or clicking like it should. Okay, hopefully this comes across on the microphone. So, left one, this does have digital tap triggers installed because it's the FPS version. Left one. Hopefully you can hear that. We've got a decent amount of travel on that. Feels and works as it should. Right one. It moves, but there's no tactile click. It's dead. Stick drift on the right analog stick. If you would also look at the USB port, as sometimes the controller disconnects while playing. Join me over at the scope and we'll check out that USB port. Here's the USB-C port under the microscope, and at first glance it looks okay. We'll just give it the wiggle test and see if there's any excess movement. I think that amount of movement is okay, so let's move on to testing. There we go, we've got 100% battery. As we can see there, that does not work at all. Crunching on that quite hard. Don't want to go any harder than that, but yep, that trigger is dead. This one feels perfect. We've got digital tap bumpers as well. Analog sticks. Yep, there's drift on the left one. Got about 8% up on that, which is not great at all. Yep. And we've got over 15% drift on the right stick going right. Yeah, 14% and up. So two new analogs. We need to check out the R2 trigger, and sometimes it's disconnecting according to the customer. I'm wailing on that USB port quite a bit, and as you can see from the tester there, we are not disconnecting at all. Let's try another one. This one is a bit newer, and again we are not getting the same failure mode as the customer. Now we've somewhat confirmed faults, the two analogs, the trigger, we will take a look at that USB port, maybe touch up the pins. If there's any type of wear and tear, damage, anything like that, we will just replace the port. But on the face of it so far, it would appear to be working perfectly fine, and I'm leaning more towards the customer's lead. However, we will check it out. So let's proceed with the disassembly, and you guys know the drill, I'll speed run it. Now we have the controller apart. Let's get this under the scope and find out what's happening with these triggers first of all. This is the left trigger, the one that works. We have our switch with the knob here, and that's what makes the clicking detent, like so. And we've got a bit of an insert that SCUF have put into the trigger, and there you go, you can see it working. So let's move over to the other side, and we have the same setup here. It's actually a spring-loaded setup here, so the force isn't put directly on the switch. As you can see here, it's just not actuating the switch. We're hitting the hard stop here, but this part isn't actually clicking the switch. Let's have a look at this side again. Okay, and that is clicking the plunger before this is hitting the dead stop. See, it clicks, and then if you look at the top here, then it still has a little bit of travel before you hit the hard stop. So click, hard stop, click, travel, hard stop. And moving this arm, that feels quite stiff, there's a fair bit of tension on that. Moving over to this one, that is really loose. So I think I know what's going on here. This arm goes across here. I'm guessing there is a crack in this plastic, so let's have a look at that and see what we can do. Ah, exactly as predicted. Over to the scope. Say it if you see it. Sorry about the lighting. But yeah, another bad design. It has fatigued the plastic. And get that in focus for you. Hello. See that gap there? That plastic is splitting. There you go, you can see that now. There's your problem. That is not good at all. If I was SCUF, I would make that out of spring steel. Okay, so this is the plastic insert that goes inside the trigger cap. So this is what actually actuates the switch, and we've got a huge crack right the way across there. You could use a piece of spring steel for this, and you could have a slot here, so you just literally slot it in sideways. So you could still keep all of this plastic, but yeah, a piece of spring steel definitely lasts longer than this. So I'm going to have to come up with an ingenious way of repairing this, or something completely different. Yeah, that's really starting to split now. After a lot of thinking and experimenting, this is what I've come up with. What I've done is I've glued that crack slightly, just so this is stable, so I can use it, because I didn't want this to break off. I have cut a channel here. So we have a metal spring backing plate. We're still retaining the original plastic. So what I need to do now, and that fits in there quite well, follows the contour, that will give support and relief to that plastic. So what I need to do now is just drill some very small holes along the body of this piece of metal, and then we will epoxy it down. The holes will be there for the epoxy to come through and give it something to grab all the way along here, and even especially right at the back here, to give it full support for that constant trigger press. So let's get on with that. Can you see how the epoxy is squidging through the holes? See that? Yeah, we really want this back part locked in there really tight, because that's where the main hinging action will happen. Okay, that's fully packed in, that is, both sides. Okay, so what we've got to do now is just let that epoxy cure. As you can see there, it's filled all the way around that metal spring and that side as well. And then we've got it coming all the way up here. We've got some small holes drilled in the spring so the epoxy can squidge through. I've got it clamped with captain tape and now with a zip tie. Not too fussed about the top end here. Most of the hinging action is going to happen roughly where that where the zip tie is anyway. That's the real pinch point, as it were. So as I said, we need to let this cure, make sure it's rock solid, and then we can probably just shape this a little bit, tidy it up with the grinding tool, especially if like this piece is in the way when we reinsert it back into the cap here. So on the whole, I'm fairly confident that this is going to be a very good repair. After about 24 hours, now the epoxy has actually cured, gone off, it's rock solid. Let's check it out under the scope. Here we go. So if you remember, we had a crack going across here, which meant this spring just didn't have any tension to press on the plunger on the button, which is why it was dead. What I've done is I've notched out a section here. I've used some spring metal, bent it to shape, put it on the contour. We've epoxied it in, there it is the other side, so we've epoxied it in there and all the way along here, notched it out to go around this plastic notch, and again it's all epoxied all the way across. Used a tiny bit of super glue just to bolster that crack, and then I have filled the gap with hot glue, Now, I'm not entirely sure if this is going to come over on the camera, but as you can see, this is very springy, spongy stuff. So it's going to support the whole springing mechanism, and that is really solid now. Absolutely rock solid. So epoxy, metal backing, and then a hot glue buffer. So let's reassemble this and see if it works. Here we are with the trigger fully assembled. I know it doesn't look pretty, but it's about as neat as I could get it. So if we look here, we have the spring coming up, and then we've got the button. There's the white plunger that makes the click. So we've got that there. And then we have this huge backstop which goes up against the back of the button here. So watch these two areas, watch this area with the white plunger, and then when that is clicked, then watch this area here where the backstop is, and then you will have a good idea of how this whole setup actually works and why it works. So push down, detent with the button. And then notice up here, once that button is clicked, there is still a gap here. And then that's what the springing action actually fights against. And if you look extremely carefully here in this area, you can actually see it compress slightly. See it all compress? It's very subtle, but it's there. Now we have a repaired trigger mechanism. And it works and it feels exactly as it should. Okay, this controller actually suffers with stick drift as well as that problem with the trigger. We've sorted out the main issue. Now we know we can continue on. So I'm just going to do a partial assembly of this, and then we will move on to replacing both sticks, calibrating them, checking it, and then final assembly and test. So you guys know the drill. I'll speed run it. there we have this PS5 Reflex FPS controller all repaired. As you saw, we had a dead right trigger. That's now repaired and it actually feels a bit better than the original, to be fair. We also replaced both of the analogs, calibrated, checked, tested, working. The controller is fully reassembled and that can go off to the customer. Again, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any issues with consoles or controllers, give us a shout. The link is in the description below. And as always, thank you for watching. Take care.